Orivu and Ricky Health Center Thilis are located a few kilometers outside Arua Central Business District. The two facilities paint a general picture of what the health system in the West Nile region is grappling with: understaffing, no electricity, and lack of running water, among other things. Besides all these challenges, these hospitals serve a population of up to 200,000 people, including urban refugees, which leaves the only referral facility, the Arua Hospital, overstretched.
Yeah, at times we have torches. If torches are not there, people, these midwives end up using their phone lights. Our greatest appeal is government to increase for us funds, which we can use for other things at our level. You know, some things like construction of inpatient ward. And also to add on that, you see, this is an OPD. It's not the standard OPD.
There is only one which I think is connected to clean water, that is Ombidi Andrea Health Center 3. But the rest are not connected to clean water, they're not connected to stable and reliable electricity, and they have a similar challenge of land ownership. Yes, the facilities are sitting on land, but there is no proof that this land belongs to this institution. So anybody can wake up one day and challenge the status quo and attempt to grab it.
Over the years, government and developing agencies have been trying to plug the gaps, but there have been persistent shortfalls. Under the new bridging program launched by the Belgium government and Enabel, 20 million euros will be spent in West Nile region to take care of the gaps in the health system, while in the Albertine region, it will be to enhance skills development.
It's really impressive, it's the change of mindset in the health facilities themselves. You can see that the staff is much more motivated, is more competent, has received trainings, so it's able to deliver much better services to the population.
Now the bridging program is also about innovation, but the innovation focus also includes a strong focus on digital for development and tackling some of the challenges of our time. These include those that are brought and reinforced by the COVID-19 pandemic.
For this region, it has not been easy. A mere city scan, you can't do it in West Nile. You have to travel to Kampala to do such a scan, and it has been very expensive. It is my prayer that such are the unique areas that are going to be identified so that equipments are brought closer.
In the Albertine region, things are beginning to move fast in the oil industry, especially after the signing of the commercial oil pipeline agreements between Uganda and Tanzania. However, locals are on the verge of missing out simply because they lack the required skill set. Officials say that the earlier local leadership embraces vocational training, the better.
So that our young people can start looking at having skills-based courses in carpentry and joinery, in electrical installation, in plumbing, name them. So that using their hands, they are able to produce what the job market requires, but also they are able to bring food on their table.
The issue of unemployment is a cancer eating away youth in Uganda, especially in upcountry towns. It is, however, hoped that through hands-on skilling, the story will change. As the old adage goes, give a man a fish, he'll eat for the day, but teach a man how to fish, he'll eat forever. John Cliff Wamala, NTV News. Oh,